वेलकम बैक।
वी ऑलरेडी सॉ दैट वेंकर्स एल्गोरिथम इज यूज्ड एज ए पार्ट ऑफ डेडलॉक अवॉइडेंस स्ट्रेटेजी। एंड व्हाट डज वेंकर्स एल्गोरिथम डू? वेंकर्स एल्गोरिथम यूज सम वेरिएबल्स एज ए पार्ट ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दोज वेरिएबल्स वेंकर्स एल्गोरिथम डिसाइड whether to physically allocate the process resources to the process or no. But we were stuck up at one place, okay, in the last lecture, that Wenkers algorithm is using one more algorithm to decide whether the newly formed state after allocation of resources to process will be a safe state or no. So we know if that state proves to be a safe state, then only physically resources are allotted to the process by Wenkers. Otherwise, resources are not allotted. So we have seen the Wenkers algorithm, but the safety algorithm which is used by Wenkers algorithm to decide on the safe or unsafe state is yet to be studied, and that is a topic of study today. So here comes a safety algorithm. Safety algorithm uses a variable work which is initialized with available. So available is a variable which is used by Wenkers. So it represents total number of available instances of a resource. Second is finish. The second variable used by safety algorithm is finish. It is initialized to false, and it is initialized to false for all the processes. So finish of I, so for all I, there can be one process, two process, 100 process, for all the processes, such that finish of I is false. So all the processes finish of I will be false. So process 1 is finish of 1 is equal to false. So by default it is false. So first, we'll start with the algorithm. It will check that for all I, for all the processes, whether the finish of I is equal to false. So the process has not yet finished. Okay. And the need of resource for that process is less than work. Now work is available. The need should not be greater than work, obviously. So the process has not finished because it needs some resources, and the required resources are lesser than the available resources. If no such I, then go to 4. And what does 4 says? If finish of I is equal to true, that means there is no process whose finish of I is false. That means all the processes finish of I is equal to true means all processes have executed successfully, they no more require any resource. That means what? The system is in safe state. Okay, but if this condition breaks, if there is any one of the process whose finish of I is false, that means the process has not yet executed completely, process needs some resource, and if the resource requirement is lesser than work, it will go to step number 3. What it will do? It will update variable work with allocation. It will try to allocate the resources. It will change finish of I is equal to true. It will go back to 2. It will again try to find out whether there is any more process who is waiting for resource to be allocated, whose finish of I is not true. It will be in this loop from 2 to 3, again 3 to 2. It will be in this same loop till the finish of I of all the processes become false. Now what will happen? Either it will come here with a conclusion that all the finish of I is true, and it will say that it is going to be a safe state. It will give this verdict back to Wenkers algorithm so that Wenkers algorithm can physically allocate the resources. Once safety algorithm tells Wenkers algorithm that there is no problem, you can allocate those resources, there won't be any unsafe state. That time, physical allocation of the resources to the process will happen. And Banker's algorithm will practically allocate those processes, resources to process. But if there are some processes whose finish of I never become true, okay, that means there is some problem. So after some timeout operation, it will come back to Banker's algorithm and say that no, system is in unsafe state. So if it is in safe state, there will be a safe sequence. And if it is not in safe state, safe sequence will not form. If the safe sequence is not forming, that time safety algorithm goes back to Banker's algorithm, tells Banker's algorithm that it is going to be an unsafe state, and Banker's algorithm will obviously again restore the variable available, max, need, okay, as well as allocation. All these variables will be restored to its original value, and physical allocation of the resources will not happen. That is how the safety algorithm is used by Banker's algorithm to decide whether the state that is formed after allocation of resources to process is okay or not. So that is all about the safety algorithm, which is used by Banker's algorithm. In the next video lecture, we are going to see the final part of deadlock handling, and that is deadlock detection. Thank you.